This instructional video covers the basics of installation of real-time smoothness equipment onto slip-form pavers. There are two systems for assessing smoothness in real-time during concrete paving operations: the Ames Real-Time Profiler and Gomeco Smoothness Indicator. Under the second Strategic Highway Research Program, SHARP-2, researchers evaluated and tested both technologies to improve process control and allow for on-the-fly equipment and operations adjustments. This corrects surface irregularities on concrete pavements during construction while the concrete is in a plastic state, reducing the need to grind the final hardened surface to achieve smoothness requirements. The initial installation takes about 20 to 30 minutes and includes mounting brackets, cables, and power connections on the slip-form paver. Once this is complete, the sensor setup only takes a few minutes at the beginning of each day. Both systems use a combination of height, slope, and distance data to calculate the smoothness in real time. One uses acoustic or sonic sensors, and the other uses a laser.
For this system, they are sonic sensors. And they get installed on this mounting arm. And these sensors are interchangeable. They can go in any of these slots, always on the same side. Tracker one is always furthest from the back of the paver, and the cables are labeled. So this is tracker one. Tracker two is closest to the back of the paver. That cable's connected. And then we'll kind of eyeball that they're hanging plumb. After the sensors have been hung on the hangers and the cables connected, just give it a quick eyeball to make sure that they're hanging plumb. Those sensors are ready to go. Then we install the shroud just for protection. Each of the real-time systems has a distance measuring device. This is the measuring wheel that goes off of the paver track, and so it will be paired up with our profile data taken by the elevation sensors and used to build a profile with. So we have a real-time smoothness display somewhere on the paver. And there's a simple cable connection here on the side. We've got the computer screen installed. We're going to turn the power on the nav pack, and our computer should boot up. Now the first thing we're going to do is go to the setup screen, diagnostics, and make sure that we're reading data from both sets of sensors. And that all looks good. We're ready to start collecting profile data. So we're going to go ahead and install the sensor for our other real-time smoothness system. Again, the initial install has all been done where the sensor arms are located in the right place. Again, a wheel path and all the power connections and cable connections have been made previously. And we're just going to finger tighten this. We want the sensor to be oriented parallel to what the paver is, and we'll be able to adjust that once the computer's connected. And then we have this cable connection. This DMI, we've used a magnet mount here just for just ease of portability, because we go from job to job. It runs off track line It could be anywhere through here where we've got enough cable, and then this cable connects here, and then the other end is at the gray box. So at this point, I'm just going to turn the computer on, and we're going to see what we've got. And then there's the real-time application is right there on the desktop. We've made all the connections. We've got an Ethernet cable that goes to the gray box from the computer. On this side of the gray box, we've got the sensor inputs, power input, and the DMI. We've got GPS with this test system, so we've got the GPS sensor here. It plugs into this gray box. At this point, all the cable connections have been made, and we're gonna power up the system. And then power up the sensors. And then open up the software application. We see our sensor heights here, so we've got good signal from our sensors. We have GPS, and system status is okay. From here, we're ready to collect real-time profile data, which involves inputting a start station, whether we're going up station or down station, and then start. That's it.
Once installed and operational, the onboard displays can be used during slip form paving to monitor smoothness immediately behind the paver in real time.